In 1975, just a year after discovering Lucy, Johanson's team got lucky again, finding a jumble of more than 200 Australopithecus afarensis fossils of teeth and bones at the site of Hadar, Ethiopia. The fossils represented around 13 to 17 individuals, including 4 children. This collection, representing as many as 17 individuals, was dubbed the first family with the official name AL333, with AL standing for Afar Locality. The vast majority of more than 200 specimens collected at AL333 during Phase 1 were surface finds. However, 18 specimens were excavated in situ from an 80-centimeter thick horizon. These fossils were collectively called the first family because they were found at the same spot. And because the fossils contained both adults and youngsters, scientists think they were probably related. Taking just these two facts in account, some researchers speculated that they may have died together and thus possibly represent a social group. However, recent examination of the deposition pattern at the site suggests otherwise. Researchers say that the first family is a snapshot of variation within Australopithecus afarensis and offers a look at how an individual within the species might have grown up. These specimens dated to around 3.2 million years ago and support the notion that Australopithecus afarensis was significantly morphic. One specimen of an infant metatarsal from an individual of approximately 1 year old at death gives further insight to the growth and development of Australopithecus afarensis and may shed light on the bipedality debate. Other than size, the group showed nearly identical anatomical features, showing they were all the same species. As to how or why these fossils were found together, the answers are yet to be confirmed. It is obvious, though, that some unknown disaster overcame this family group, burying them all at the same time. Some carnivore tooth marks suggested that this first family were victims of something like lion or leopard predation. A catastrophic flood is another theory. However, anthropologists are still trying to figure out what led to the demise of such a large group of hominids. Whatever disaster befell the group, and regardless of whether the first family died together and represented a social group, Australopithecus afarensis likely lived in groups for protection and possibly cooperation. It is seen that males were much larger than females, and thus the degree of sexual dimorphism was much greater than in our own species. This important find has allowed scientists to gather insights into the biology and development of a single fossil species. It also provided evidence that this species lived in small groups based on possible family bonds. And with that, we have come to the end of the video. Thanks for watching and hope you enjoyed it. For more videos like these, check our channel out and please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella and see you soon in our next video.